Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 24th September, on the front page you have Shah moots one card for all utilities. So Home Minister Amit Shah says that 2021 census will be digital and could prepare a base for it. So this initiative is of having one card. So he was speaking at the foundation stone laying ceremony for construction for new building of Registrar General of India. So he said digital census has the potential to bring all cards such as Aadhaar, passport, bank accounts and driving license on one platform. And this is Rawat hints at stronger action as Pakistan revives Balakot camp. So this is Chief of Army Staff General Bipin Rawat, who has indicated that India's response to the revival of the terrorist camp at Balakot in Pakistan could go beyond airstrikes. So the Balakot airstrikes were conducted by India after the Pulwama attacks. So here you can see it is said by him that 500 people are waiting to infiltrate into the country. Then below you have renewable energy target to be more than doubled. So India has made a commitment for renewable energy. It was creation of 175 gigawatts renewable energy by 2022, which is India's commitment under Paris Climate Agreement. Now India will decided it will increase this target to more than double, from 175 to 450 gigawatts. So this will be announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi is there at United Nations Climate Action Summit in New York City. So this is the news. Also, you should know that earlier India has modified the definition of renewable energy. Earlier, renewable energy included only small hydro projects, but now the government has recently changed that definition to include also all hydroelectric projects, because hydroelectricity is also considered as renewable energy. So when all of them will be included, so of course there'll be more more of renewable energy which is possible. But creation, that will be actually data change, but creation as such is questionable. We will have to see. Then this is mob beats up man for cow smuggling in Alwar. So a mob of cow vigilance beat up a man alleging that he was smuggling half a dozen cows to Haryana in Haryana. So this happened in Rajasthan's Alwar district. Then on page 8 you have Vemnad model to track CRZ violations. So coastal regulation zone, regulations violation would be tracked through Vemnad model. So this is a model of identifying changes in the coastal belt. So this could be emulated, copied to track illegal structures along the Kerala coast. So you can see it took just a fortnight for geoscientists in 2013 to identify the major changes in the 100 meter coastal regulation zone, which could be probable CRZ violations. So this is the Vemnad model, as it said. It could be tried along the entire Kerala coast is being proposed here. And this is survey of dragonflies hints at impact of floods. So alarming fall in odonate population, that is these flies, dragonflies population in Kerala, is what is being seen as an impact of floods. So this survey was held in Silent Valley National Park and it discovered 8 new species but reported an alarming decrease in the odonate population. That is, and this is giant earthworm found at the foot of Western Ghats. This may not be so important, but such topics you can use because UPSC asks questions like floods is on disaster management, and then this is biodiversity on environment. So how disasters affect the environment, or some such question, you can yourself put in such a point which will give weightage to your answer. Then on page 9 you have Justice Bhatt, who had put CJI under RTI, is now now Supreme Court judge. So there were 4 judges sworn in to the Supreme Court, and one of them is Justice S. Ravindra Bhatt, who exactly 10 years ago as Delhi High Court judge had dismissed a Supreme Court appeal and had declared the office of the Chief Justice of India subservient to the RTI regime. He had declared Chief Justice of India as the post of Chief Justice of India as a public authority. And below you have Pradhan Mantri Arogya Yojana, Jan Arogya Yojana, or the Ayushman Bharat scheme as it is called. This completed a year now, and it was said that 46.4 lakh hospital treatments worth 7,500 crore was undertaken, with 60% of the amount being spent on tertiary care. So there have been 10 crore cards which have been given. So it is said this has resulted in saving of over 12,000 crore to the beneficiary families. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Texan outreach. So it says, though both leaders gained from the Houston rally, it was not diplomacy at its best. So this Houston gathering of Indian diaspora in US, which was addressed jointly by Prime Minister Narendra Modi and US President Donald Trump, it is considered as successful, but this editorial says that it was not the best that we could have got out of it. So the diaspora in the US is also the Indian diaspora. It is said to be of preeminent significance. It has political heft, and it is also, you know, US is central to India's strategic architecture. So in that context, this meet was significant, but then emphasis was on radical Islamic terrorism emerging from Pakistan. And Prime Minister Modi gave a boost to, you know, almost approved President Trump as the candidate for re-election in USA. So that did not result in everybody endorsing it. It was divided response which he got. And then here you have credibility deficit. So this is regarding Justice Qureshi's episode. So Justice A. Qureshi, he was recommended by the Supreme Court Collegium and then to be appointed as Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court. And later Collegium decided, after the government gave it letters, the Collegium decided to send him to Tripura High Court. So, and it was quite apparent that Centre was averse to the elevation of Justice Qureshi, who is from Gujarat High Court, but serving in Bombay High Court on transfer. So this is credibility deficit which has been evident, because it raises fresh questions about Collegium's role in appointment of judges. And here you have the lead article, making the grand Indian public sector bank mergers work. So it says, only visionary leadership can bring the efficiency parameters of the merged entities in line with those of private banks. So public sector banks merger has taken place, but still the visionary leadership which would be required to bring them on par with private banks. And this is climate justice through judicial diktat. So this is regarding the Maradu case. So the Supreme Court had given its order for demolition in the apartments in Maradu, which is a suburb in Ernakulam. So it is regarding environment laws violated. So the liability is squarely on the apartment owners now. So this is being questioned, that the whole gamut involved in these apartments being built up in the first place, all that, the transactions which would have gone into getting this approval, all that also has to be looked into. So this point is being picked up here in this article on climate justice. On the op-ed page, you have the importance of listening well. So this is regarding conversations between governments and citizens, and among citizens themselves. So this is very important, conversations, listening as such, this is crucial in a democracy. And this is inequality of another kind. This is why the right to internet access and digital literacy should be recognized as a right in itself. So that point is being highlighted, that there is digital inequality. Then on page 12, you have healthy life, a basic right. PM tells UN meet. So this is regarding how India is ready to share experience in providing affordable health care with all developing countries. So India's experience and capabilities will be shared. This is what the Prime Minister said at the first ever high level meeting on universal health coverage in New York as such. So this was the UN meet held here. Then on page 13, you have intelligence inputs warn of terror strikes. So there's a general alert which is going on and will continue till the festive season, as militants may attempt a hit, say officials. So here you can see army sources said there were strong inputs of major infiltration attempts along the LOC in the next 3 to 4 days. And this is won't brook interference, CJI. So Supreme Court has issued a general
a general reprimand against interference in judicial appointments and transfers, saying such intrusions did not augur well for the institution. So this was admonition from a bench led by CJI in a petition filed by Gujarat High Court Advocates Association regarding proposed appointment of Justice A.A. Qureshi. So he, as the editorial also speaks of, that he has been he was originally proposed to be appointed to Madhya Pradesh High Court as CJI. Now he has been appointed to Tripura High Court as CJI. Then we also had Tahil Ramani case recently, in which she was proposed to be transferred from Madras High Court, being Chief Justice of Madras High Court, to a Northeastern High Court with not much strength. So she preferred to resign rather than being transferred there, considering it as a demotion. And this is, faith of Hindus will be hard to rebut, says Supreme Court. So Supreme Court says that the faith of Hindus in the Ram Janmabhoomi has been constant and it will be hard to refute it. But then the council fighting for Muslims, he says, belief alone is not enough for claiming a title, claiming, you know, hold on a land. So this arguments in the Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid title dispute case is going on within this context. On international page, you have Russia formally accepts 2015 Paris Climate Accord. So Russia said it would implement the 2015 Paris Agreement to fight climate change after its Prime Minister approved a government resolution signifying Moscow's final acceptance of the deal. It first signed the deal in April 2016, but now it has formally accepted it too. So Russia is the world's fourth largest emitter of greenhouse gases and the biggest emitter not to have ratified the landmark global climate deal. So this is there. Russia said it did not need to ratify the agreement because Moscow had already undertaken to honor its commitments when it signed the deal in April 2016. And you should know, US has opted out of the Paris Climate Agreement. Then on business page 2, this is SBI, State Bank of India specific news, and this is regarding the Petronet company which signed an MOU with US based company for LNG, liquefied natural gas deal. So that we have discussed yesterday. So here you have one news, biofuel planes may fly 10 crore passengers by 2030. So this is what India has committed to fly. 10 crore passengers on biofuel propelled planes by 2030. This is what SpiceJet chairman and managing director says. There are also plans to he says that we must also develop electric aircraft. So these are also plans again specific to Jet Airways, SpiceJet. So this is there. So these are the important headlines. There is no news on the last page too. So that is it. Thank you.